Hi, it's Stacy, and welcome to another Stacy Monday Morsel. I hope that you're doing well and that your week's off to a good start. So diving right in. So today I want to talk about keeping focus, because something I notice, and I said this before, and I've been saying this for the last couple of weeks, we plan all these things that we want to bring into the new year, and it's really, really easy to get distracted, to fall off, whatever term you want to use. But a lot of that comes from our programming. We have habits. We have these things that we do, and the people we see and talk to and places we go. And the thing about making change is that you gotta make change. I have this thing, like when I drive, I don't like driving down the same street all the time because I want to see something new. I believe in that. And it's the same thing when you're trying to change your life or when you're trying to improve your life. A lot of times you have to maybe step outside of what you normally do so that you can achieve the things that you want to achieve. Let me say that again. You have to step outside of what you normally do so that you can achieve what you want to achieve. The thing that we don't often put together, you know, I always say change brings change, and that's the thing. You can't keep doing the same thing and expecting a different result. That is what? The definition of insanity. But more so, it is what keeps us in the rut. It's what keeps us from moving ahead and getting to the things we want to get to. And then we sit there and we go, I'm just not good at this. No, you kept doing what you did before. So with this new year, you have to bring a new attitude. You have to think differently. You have to do things that you've never done before, to have something that you've never had. And that requires you to put yourself in the place, in the position of what it is you say you want. You have to think in that way. So if you're saying, we'll just use weight, because that's the thing everybody always wants to work with. If you want to lose weight, if you want to be successful on your diet, you definitely cannot do the things you've done. You cannot go to the places you've gone to. And you might even have to do the 21-day retraining. You know, they say that you can form a new habit in 21 days. So you might need that 21 days to just recondition yourself. So it means you may have to miss something that you always do when you say, oh, well, I'll just pick something different off the menu. No, no, no. How about if you just don't go there for the 21 days? Because the purpose is for you to shift your mindset, to change how you look at things. And as this new year comes up, this is how we fall off, get distracted, and don't achieve the things that we want to achieve, is because we haven't started thinking in a different way than we've thought before. And it requires a different way of thinking, is required to change for a different way of being. And so instead of being frustrated that you've fallen off, because you know, we're really good at going, oh, well. But you don't have to say, oh, well. And I've said this before. You've got the next minute, the next hour, the next day to get back on and do the things that you want to do and to achieve the things that you want to achieve. So you have to stay in your mindset. You can't lose focus. You have to decide, okay, I want to eat better. So one of the things I always recommend, for those that follow my more healthy stuff, is that I am the queen of food prep. Although it is healthier to juice on, you know, every morning or when you're going to juice, that's not convenient for everybody. It's not convenient for me. And so I learned how to juice on Sunday. It isn't the best, and I know it's not the freshest, but I learned if I juice on Sunday and I put my juice in mason jars, one, it stays better in glass, and two, I am more likely to juice because the juice is there and it's available. If I had to get up every morning and juice, trust and believe, it would not happen. One, not the juicing, but the, not the juicing, but the putting, but having to clean the juicer every single day wouldn't happen. So I juice on Sunday, I put my juice in a mason jar, and that keeps me through the week. And that's how I know that I'm going to get that juice in my stomach and I'm going to do the thing for myself that I need to do. And it's the same thing with the way that I eat. due to my health challenges, I have had to make sure I have what I need. And to make sure I have what I need, I have to food prep. So on Sunday, I have allotted time for the food prep. I've allotted time to make sure all my food is made. And that way, I don't have to worry about falling off and eating something I shouldn't eat because I have what I have to have. And so, and the food thing is no different than anything else you want to do. Everything that I've ever done has required prep. It's required me to be prepared. And that is the same thing as any goal you want to achieve. You just have to get your preparation in order. If there's something else that you want to do, it requires you to start lining that up so that you can be successful. So don't get discouraged. Don't lose focus. Just put yourself in a better position. Preparation is everything. It makes such a difference and whether or not we succeed or not. So think about that as you're moving forward into the year. And if maybe you've fallen off a little bit from the things that you're trying to do, just think about the things that you could do that will help you to stay focused. Because it's all about changing your mindset and changing your actions so that you can achieve the things that you want to achieve. So, more than anything, this was sort of that pep talk to tell you, do not give up. Just because you didn't have a good week last week or a good day or a good hour, or a good day, minute, moment, whatever, don't give up. Stay focused and get prepared. Get your preparation together. Get a system. Sometimes I have my day scheduled, my Sunday. Sunday morning, I wake up, I juice, I food prep. I know that I'm going to do those things. Just like I don't work out really well in the afternoon. So whatever time I have to leave the house, I get up 2 hours ahead so that I can get on the treadmill for an hour and go do my bands. Meditate. I have a whole thing that happens for me in the morning because if it had happened at night, there would be no routine, no schedule, there'd be no pattern, and more than likely I'd walk in the house and go to bed. So to make sure that I do everything I need to do, I am always prepared. If you stay ready, you don't have to get ready. So I didn't make that up, I just repeated it. But anyway, that's my Monday morsel for today. Stay ready so you ain't got to get ready. Get yourself prepared for what you want. Prepare for where you're trying to go. Don't just sit there and talk about it. Change about it. All right, this is Stacy. I hope that you have an amazing rest of the week. I will see you later. Love and blessings. Bye-bye.